run over the last 4 minutes. Deuce McBride hit a bucket and an and one. Knicks led by 8, but the Sixers on this run, and they've evened it up here. 3.5 to go in regulation. Another one that's going to come right down to the end. As Hartenstein keeps it going.
I'll tell you what, that is a difficult shot. He's making it look easy, and Brunson just continues to set him up to at least his 4th assist to Hartenstein.
Maxey, as McBride knocks Embiid to the ground.
On Maxey, I'm a little surprised. Even Chinzo having a good offensive night. Surprised we haven't seen him.
Joel Embiid trying to give the Sixers the lead, cannot, and is an offensive board. Harris looking for help. Lowry kicks it, but 2 for 3. No. Lowry with the rebound and a loose ball foul on McBride.
Three opportunities, and DiVincenzo will indeed be coming back.
31 here tonight. 6 points, make it 7 points as he hits 1 out of 2. It's a 1-point game with 3 minutes to go in game 2. Series that'll shift to Philadelphia Thursday for game 3. Knicks up 1-0 in this series after they grinded out a fourth quarter in game 1 and made 6 3-pointers in the fourth quarter in game 1. Brunson with Tobias Harris on him. That was a tough shot. He can't get it. DiVincenzo pulls down the board and is fouled immediately. This light the lamp. A challenge here with 2:37 left in reg.
After the rebound, Lowry makes contact with the ball, which causes the ball to come loose. Therefore, there is no foul in the play.
Wow.
At the time of the whistle, there was imminent possession by Embiid. Therefore, it will be Philadelphia's basketball. Philadelphia retains their timeout.
That is a huge challenge. 4 minutes left in the third quarter. It's been a tight one, just as we thought it would be with these two teams. Maxey gives it to Embiid, gives it right back. Maxey rises up and hits a mid-range jumper. Philadelphia back in front, 97-96. Maxey's got 32.
Yeah, those two guys, Embiid and Maxey, combining for 66 of the 97.
Big first, big fourth quarters for Tyrese Maxey. Playing under the weather tonight. Brunson driving on Harris, contact. Brunson comes up short, Harris with a rebound. Maxey wants to push it. Josh Hart is back. Maxey loses the handle and turns it over. Knicks ball with 1:51 left.
Well, Knicks need to get into their action a little quicker. They're not getting into any action until like 10 or 11 on the shot clock. Just not giving themselves enough time.
Set up for a finish here. Knicks can grab the lead back. Hart left wide open, short. Nick Nurse sticks with his strategy to leave Hart open, to sag off of him. He made him pay in game 1. A big miss here. Maxey, guarded by Hart, sticking with him, can't dribble himself free. Now Embiid takes on Hartenstein. Maxey for 3. He got it! Tyrese Maxey gives the Sixers a 4-point lead. Clutch 3-pointer from Maxey. 11 of those 18 points in this run. It covers a little over 6 minutes. Do the Knicks have an answer now? Have not scored in 2.5. Brunson miss it. Hartenstein offensive rebound. Digs it out. Another opportunity here for the Knicks. Under a minute to go and a foul. Down 4. Tyrese Maxey has gone off in this fourth quarter. DiVincenzo to Ananobi. Around the horn it goes. Brunson. Brunson, 3-pointer. Short. Hartenstein back tap. And it's going to be a foul on DiVincenzo. Kyle Lowry makes it a 5-point.
For the series, they are going to struggle.
1 out of 2. The Knicks racing up the floor. Brunson with the Knicks down 5. Here's Hart, gives it back. Batum on Brunson. A lot of clock ticking here. Lowry got the pick. DiVincenzo comes out of the pack. DiVincenzo finds Brunson. Great defense here by the Sixers. Brunson gets a prayer of a bounce. two-point game. Maxey hits the deck. Hart takes it from him. Shot clock is off. DiVincenzo, no. Hartenstein with an offensive rebound. Another chance here. DiVincenzo, he's got it. The Knicks have the lead again. Their defense turning into offense. What a flurry for the Knickerbockers.
And get the ball to Maxey coming on the fly from the backcourt. They couldn't, so they go to him.
Maxey drives. Maxey blocked by Hartenstein. And Anobi comes away with a board, and Hartenstein stands
taller, though. He makes this free throw. I'm taking a foul coming up the floor. I'm not going to give him a chance to get off a three.
Sixers down three. Maxey with two, with one. Embiid's going to have to put it up for the tie. Oh, he missed it, and that's the ball game. A flurry at the end of game two for the Knicks, and they win it 104-101 and take a two.
And now playing free, unsaddled by foul trouble.
The Knicks trying to use Halliburton's man to set the screen, but they were able to switch the matchups and get Halliburton back over to DiVincenzo.
And now Nembhard on Brunson. Three-pointer flies, and Brunson rips the cords, makes it a two-point game. A wow. Contested three.
Wow, and that's his first made three of the night.
12 in the corner for Brunson. Coming right down to the finish line. Halliburton. And it's stripped by Anunoby. The long reach of Anunoby. Pacers turn it over. Knicks can grab the lead here with a three ball. Three and a half to go. Brunson catching his breath. Neesmith. An excellent defender on him. And Brunson draws the contact. Brunson to the line. Fourth foul on Aaron Neesmith.
Well, here's Brunson coming up, Nembhard on him. Maybe just a little too much space, but then Anunoby, the great steal. And then Brunson able to drive the ball on Neesmith and get himself to the free throw line.
Brunson's made all his free throws tonight. 10 of 10, struggled from the line late in that Sixers series. What a game, what a setting. Brunson, one free throw remaining. He's tied this game. Nine ties, five lead changes. The biggest lead was Indiana's nine-point lead. Knicks had an eight-point lead at one point. They have played it tight here in game one. Halliburton working with Turner. Turner stopped, and they turn it over. Anunoby, Anunoby puts the Knicks in front. Stephon Marbury enjoying it. Pacers need a bucket. Siakam comes right back. Missed it. He slipped.
And OG Anunoby's defense is taking over right here. Two steals and then a big stop on his former teammate Siakam.
7-0 run. Knicks lead by two. Brunson over Nembhard. Cash it in.
As automatic in the clutch as it gets. He's got 38. Going after his fourth consecutive 40-point game in the playoffs. DiVincenzo de-cleats Aaron Neesmith. Is called for the foul. He's upset. DiVincenzo picks up number five.
There's Anunoby with his second straight steal and down and finishes it. And then Brunson on the step back over Nembhard. Yeah. Brunson has 16 in the quarter, and Stephon Marbury loves it.
What a feeling that must be to get a guy like Marbury to react like that in a game like this.
Well, remember, Stephon Marbury is not only a Knicks alum, he's a New York City guy.
Thomas Moore!
As is the guy next to him. Clyde Frazier. The chill approach. Neesmith, big free throws right there in the clutch. Knicks lead it by two, 2.5 to go. Harden running the baseline, finds Ananobi. Court pressure is on here. Trying to keep the ball out of Brunson's hands. The Villanova three have been electric here in this fourth quarter. Hart gets a step. Showed it. Nothing there. Turns it over. Up ahead. Here's Siakam who lays it in. Nembhard set him up beautifully. We are tied at 113.
Well, as much as Josh Hart's done, that was his fifth turnover of the night. And Indiana worked hard with the pressure to not let Brunson handle and to make someone else make a play.
Nembhard trying to contain Brunson. Halliburton called for the foul. He does not believe it was a foul, and he is asking his crew to take a look. Let's see if we have a challenge here.
After review, it's been determined that Halliburton made legal contact with the basketball. It is a successful challenge. Imminent possession goes to Indiana as they recover the loose ball. It's a successful challenge.
Wow. So they've each got two timeouts left, and each have a challenge remaining.
What a way to start this series. This old school 90s rivalry. DiVincenzo gets a step. Nembhard, wow, what a layup in traffic.
That is now 62 points in the paint for the Pacers, who lead the league in that category.
Nembhard with 11. He scored at least 12 in the last five playoff games. And guarding Brunson here. Brunson shifty, looking for contact. Brunson got it. Tied once again. Brunson with 40. Fourth consecutive game. Nembhard not afraid. In and out it goes. Brunson the rebound. Under a minute to go. Two timeouts each. And that is a kicked ball.
The players.
Brunson with a ball in his hands. Sitting on 40. Kicks it, DiVincenzo, three-pointer, down it goes! Dante DiVincenzo puts the Knicks up three!
Wow. Does Indiana try to go quick on a two-for-one? Looks like they would like to.
Siakam falls down, a little bit of a scramble here. Siakam guarded by Ananobi. Two former Raptors going at it. Siakam, strong layup. Knicks still lead it by a point. 2 seconds. Shot separating shot clock and game clock. And Sean Wright looking for help here. Three officials come together, and Tyler Ford comes in and says Pacers ball. Neither Zarba or Wright were able to make that call. And Tom Thibodeau takes the timeout to challenge this.
After review, the ball was determined to go off Nembhard's left leg. It is a successful challenge. New York basketball with 22.4 on the game clock, 19 on the shot clock.
Now to advance, 3.4 second differential. They do not need to take a foul here.
Ooh, almost gave it away. Now Brunson is surrounded. Brunson throws it off Halliburton, and that'll be Knicks ball.
No, it's going to be
Indiana ball.
Back and hit Brunson out of bounds.
Saw it that way as well. Pacers ball. Here is Halliburton. Shot clock is off. Indiana down a point at Madison Square Garden. And Turner will be called for an offensive foul on the screen.
That is shocking. You never see that call at this point in the game.
Wow.
I mean, never.
DiVincenzo hit the deck, sold it.
That is a great acting job. A lot of great actors here in New York City. You see them on Broadway all the time. That's as good an acting job as you'll see. He technically was moving a little bit. Indiana's going to challenge.
Ruling on the floor is an offensive foul on Turner. Indiana's challenging the ruling. After review, it's determined that Turner does not give his opponent time to stop or change direction on this screen. Therefore, it's an unsuccessful challenge and an illegal screen on Turner. Ruling on the floor stands.
There you go.
You don't have a timeout to stop the clock, and that's a killer right there.
Yeah, Brunson draws the foul on Nembhard. But the ball is
It's really costly because if Brunson makes this, then you have to foul again, and they can turn it into a two-possession game.
Brunson has been clutch from the line tonight. Knicks ball again. Trying to get the ball to Brunson. He's got it. Got a foul here, and that's going to send Brunson to the free throw line.
They learned from game five to game six in the Philly series. They didn't take the foul in game five. They took fouls in game six to prevent the three. No timeouts for Indiana. They're saying right now, no foul, but I don't know if that's if Brunson makes it or not.
Brunson to give the Knicks a four-point lead with 10.7 left. Center cut. Hasn't missed at the line tonight. Pacers got to go quick. They're down four, up ahead. Halliburton looked like he rolled his ankle and turns it over. Knicks have it. OG Anunoby dribbles it out. And game one belongs to the New York Knicks.
Oubre guarding now McBride. Kelly Oubre has five steals tonight. Anunoby. Hart. McBride. Gets inside, pulls up, jumper won't go. Robinson the rebound, the putback, second one is good. Mitchell Robinson, a monster on the offensive glass. Knicks have 21 offensive rebounds. Maxey forced left. Now back up top to Embiid. Embiid looking at Robinson, step back jumper, won't go. Josh Hart, the rebound, lost it. Hart trying to save it, and he can't. Sixer ball. Embiid, Batum, Maxey, Oubre, and Lowry out there for Philadelphia. Boy, Tom Thibodeau wanted to travel. He may have been right on that one. Embiid against Robinson. Shot clock at four. Embiid backing in. Shot clock at two. Turns, shoots, just gets it off in time. Hart grabs the rebound, his 11th. Maxey trying to deny Brunson. Maxey has played some excellent defense tonight. Brunson off the bounce. Pull-up jump shot. Got it!
You got to know that he loves to reject screens, right? I mean, help is coming one side. He's like, I'm going opposite.
That's his first points of the fourth quarter. Now 22, Maxey. Thought about a three, but Robinson made him change his mind. Shot clock at six again. Embiid calling for Maxey to get it. Brunson does a good job. Embiid a three. Won't go. Rebound Hart. There he is once again pursuing the rebound. Brunson falling away. Short gets his own rebound. Goes inside. Wild pass. And they're going to call a foul on Brunson. Boy, that's a delayed call.
I don't know how you argue that call. An offensive foul on Jalen Brunson.
No, Brunson picks up his first. Lowry up top to Batum. Now Embiid. Backs in against Mitchell Robinson. Tough shot off the mark. Fight for the rebound, and I mean a fight. And Robinson and Embiid will have a hell of a ball. What a battle between the two big men. I don't know if I've ever seen that. Embiid kind of the quick tip, and the Sixers get the ball. Maxey with eight on the 24. Long three-pointer. It's good! Tyrese Maxey from way downtown, and it's a three-point game. 29 from Maxey. Winning a jump ball, what a huge turnaround. Brunson with seven to shoot. Cross court to Hart. Josh Hart, a three-pointer. Puts it in! Josh Hart, some clutch three-pointers. And it's back to a six-point game. He's got 8 points here in the fourth. Maxey looking up top to Embiid. Embiid draws, goes right at Robinson, and a foul.
Motion, though, Mike.
Absolutely.
Can we talk a little bit about Josh?
17 points, 12 rebounds for Hart. Meanwhile, Embiid continues to knock down free throws. So important for Joel Embiid. He's 11 of 12 from the free throw line. 4-point game with just over a minute and a half remaining. Brunson looking, pulls back. Harris is on him. Cross court, Ananobi. Ananobi a three. Bang! OG Ananobi from downtown. Timeout, Philadelphia. A 7-point lead with 128. He missed 27 of 30 games with a right elbow, but in the 23 games he's played, the Knicks are 20-3. Kyle Lowry looks to answer and does. Lowry with a clutch three-pointer. And it's back to a 4-point game. Dwight Lowry never quits. 18 points in 37 minutes. That's his fourth three-pointer. Shot clock down to 9. McBride has it. Lowry guarding him. Now at 5. Shot clock at 4. Hart fakes. Hart tries another three-pointer. Oh, it's good! Knocks down another! Seven-point lead, under a minute to play. Hart hasn't sat the entire second half. Maxey brings it out. Maxey drives. Layup is good. Another gorgeous drive to the bucket. 5-point game. Knicks will try and take some time off the clock. Brunson trying to get away from a double team. And there's the foul. It all season. That was the first foul in the last 2 minutes. Robinson. And a smart play. Oh, and Embiid just shoves down Brunson. Airborne into Joel Embiid.
Right.
Robinson hits the free throw. Two free throws for Mitchell Robinson. He's got 12 rebounds, 7 of them offensive. And the Knicks lead by 7. Maxey drives on Robinson, gets past him. Another quick layup. Hardly any time went off the clock. Lightning quick as Maxey. McBride has it. Back to Brunson. 5-point game now to Ananobi. And they really need the foul. Ananobi, a lot of time going off the clock. Finds its way to McBride. Now Brunson, still no foul. Brunson back up top. 5 on the 24. Ananobi drives, goes inside. Leans in, jump shot, won't go. And the rebound goes to Josh Hart, and that'll do it. Knicks hold on in a tough physical game.
Really makes no sense.
And Josh Hart down 5 with under 30 seconds to not foul. And for Josh Hart, again, the pursuit of the basketball. This guy could play on all 30 teams. Who wouldn't want that guy on your team? Knicks take game one.
4:40 to go in the fourth quarter. Knicks a 2-1 series edge. Philadelphia basketball after the astute play from Maxey. Oubre gets denied. And it will stay here. By the way, Tom Thibodeau sticking with Precious Achiuwa. Hartenstein on the bench with 5 fouls.
Well, great job by Precious, but you want to go with whatever the flow is. Hartenstein, if you could hold him for the last 2 minutes, whatever it takes, he probably would have came back into this game if the Knicks started to struggle a little bit more than what they are. But right now, they've got a lead with 4 to go. They just have to play good basketball.
Maxey unable to hit the 3. McBride the rebound. Here is Brunson. Working behind Achiuwa, Brunson with 42 points, 10 assists. Brunson gives it up, 3 to shoot, hard on the ball fake. His floater rolls off, rebound knocked out of bounds, and it will stay with the Knicks again.
Except for that last steal that Joel Embiid got.
Under 4 minutes to go in the fourth quarter of game 4. Brunson. Here's McBride. He'll fire, and he's fouled. McBride is fouled and will shoot 3 free throws. McBride misses the first free throw, 86% on the season. Crowd looking for Chick-fil-A. I'm not sure how it works when you shoot.
Just so that, you know, if he
gets
misses
the crowd
too.
Going.
Yeah, gets the crowd going.
McBride hits both. hits the final two after missing the first. So 92-89, Knicks lead it. McBride with 13 off the bench. Knicks without Mitchell Robinson in this game. And Bojan Bogdanović got injured in the second quarter, the first moments he was in the game, and has been unable to return. Shot clock down to six already. Embiid flagging it down. Shot clock at three. Embiid hopping, taking, left it short. Rebound Knicks. Brunson able to evade Lowry, and it last hits Brunson. It's Philadelphia basketball. Every possession so precious in these moments. 3:15 to go in the fourth quarter of game four. Here's Maxey, gets free. McBride did a nice job getting back to Maxey.
Not good for Blantz. They're just playing back and forth between the two guards.
Lowry gives it up. Embiid gets denied by Achiuwa.
Plays that start bad often end bad. That is a common term in the NBA universe.
Brunson, no. Achiuwa, and he's fouled. Achiuwa is fouled by Lowry. The fifth personal on Lowry.
The Philadelphia 76ers are not grabbing the ball. They're not boxing out. They're not doing the little things as well as the Knicks are, and that's been the difference thus far.
Here's Achiuwa off the inbound. 10 to shoot. Hart has it. Knicks lead by three. Hart will fire. Can't hit. Rebound Anunoby. Another offensive rebound for New York. Number one in the league this season, showing why today. Brunson's jumper short. Another O-board. McBride. No. It hits Achiuwa. And finally, Philadelphia basketball. Their 17th offensive rebound on that possession for the Knicks. 2:10 to go in the fourth. Knicks with a three-point lead. Maxey looking for Embiid. Shot clock down to eight. Maxey, the step back jumper short. Rebound Brunson.
Not seeing enough movement from Philadelphia. They're very deliberate right now in the wrong kind of way. Getting late in the shot clock, not getting movement around Joel and Maxey. I think both teams are fatigued right now, but the Knicks just look sharper.
Embiid has not sat in this second half. Brunson into the lane. Brunson gets fouled by Harris. And Jalen Brunson, who has 42 already, will go to the line. Franchise playoff record is 46 by Bernard King. He misses. Rebound tipped by Anunoby, and it's out of bounds to Philadelphia. 93-89, New York in front, 1:31 to go in the fourth. See if Philadelphia gets a little more movement here on this possession, with Oubre bringing it up the floor. Oubre will take the three, can't hit. Lowry the rebound, looking for Embiid, finds him. Lowry gives it up. Maxey into the corner. Harris hit it to three. Rebound loose. Grabbed by Brunson. He has it for New York. 105 to go in the fourth. Brunson off to Hart. Back to Brunson. Wasting time. Brunson floats it in. 45 for Jalen Brunson. And a six-point Knicks lead. New York trying to take a 3-1 series edge, and Philadelphia has been able to get nothing going offensively against this Knicks defense over the last few minutes of the fourth.
You want to give 100% credit to the Knicks defense, but also Philly, their organization, that double high screen that they were running with Lowry and Maxey just looked confusing.
Embiid gets a foul here and will go to the line to shoot too. Conditioning has been ramping up after he missed so much of the season with that knee surgery. Misses the free throw here. He has not sat.
It kind of seems like it's in mud around him.
Embiid hits the second free throw. 5-point Knicks lead. 54 seconds to go in the fourth quarter. Hart, who's navigated beautifully with five fouls in this fourth, gets it into Anunoby. Anunoby skates it across to Hart.
You don't want to foul here.
Backs it out. Brunson, shot clock at 10. Trapped. Finds Anunoby. 7 to shoot. Hart. 5 to shoot. Hart stops. Loses. Loose ball. Embiid has it for Philadelphia. Up ahead to Maxey. Maxey into the lane. Was stripped. It will stay here with Philly. 26.9 seconds remaining, and the Knicks holding a 5-point lead, and the Knicks can challenge this and will.
That is, that their offenses look discombobulated before that.
The call on the floor stands. Philadelphia ball.
Yeah, replay center making the call there, and understandably so. It stands because there's just nothing conclusive there. Achiuwa pressuring. And a whistle. How about this? That's a whistle before the ball is inbounded. So this is going to be
Kyle Lowry doing Kyle Lowry things. You respect it. It's so tough, but he knows. He knows.
Is under review for potential away from the play foul.
Yeah, so an away from the play foul is one free throw. Anybody on your team can shoot it, plus you retain possession.
You saw the three-pointer that he was able to draw the foul on there. Always one of the league leaders in charges taken. Right there, that might not be.
Four-point game as Maxey hits the free throw. Batum inbounds. Embiid fakes the jumper, flies inside, and can't finish. Hart the board, and Hart is fouled.
If he would have taken one, two dribbles and took it off, that would have been a much better attempt instead of that jumper.
Knicks in the bonus. Hart at the line misses the first. Thibodeau today and has come through in a big way. Hart misses both. Rebound Batum. Door open for Philadelphia. Here's Lowry. 15 seconds remaining. Maxey dashing, turning, kicking. Lowry's three off the mark. Follows it up and gets fouled. Kyle Lowry going to the line.
He has 6 points, but it feels like he's had a bigger impact in this game.
Lowry hits the first. Lowry misses. It's tipped out. Brunson has it. And the Knicks will send Brunson to the line on the brink of a game four victory.
If you know you're going to miss, Maxey and everyone has to dive in. That was miscommunication by the Philadelphia 76ers.
Brunson has 46. A new franchise playoff record, 47 points for Jalen Brunson.
They were running out of time. There wasn't enough time to get the shots up and to foul and do all the necessary things.
Embiid misses, and that will do it. The Knicks hang on in game four and take a commanding 3-1 series lead.
Brunson. Toss it. It is DiVincenzo. Too strong. Back to Hartenstein. To Hart. Anunoby. He's going to drive it. Oh! Anunoby with a grown man's jam.
Justin with that tip out. Great awareness to find OG.
The foul on Embiid, but OG Anunoby can't convert at the line. It's 109-101 with 2:36 to go. Embiid. He comes to the ball, swing it back, Embiid to the corner. Oubre lines it up. Oubre! Yes, sir! On a three!
And it wasn't an easy three. It was contested well by OG Anunoby. But it's really right now, it's going to be getting stops if you're Philadelphia and making sure you defensive rebound here down the stretch.
109-104 Knicks. What a series! Brunson nearly lost it. Gathers, drives, can't finish.
2 minutes.
Harris gets it ahead for Maxey. Maxey with the herky-jerky moves. Oh, he spins it in! Perfect amount of English from Tyrese Maxey. He got a three-point game. Down to 1:45 to go. No lead is safe.
And now Philadelphia getting the ball out of Brunson's hands, double-teaming him on the catch.
Brunson looks at the clock, gives it up. Hart drives, floats, missed it, tip, no! Embiid secures! 1:25 left in the fourth. Knicks holding on to a three-point lead. Embiid Spin, fake, kick. Harris, baseline delivery. Does it go? Kelly Oubre, get on up. It's a one-point game. 7-0 burst from the Sixers. We're down to 1 minute to go in game six.
Ethan from the New York Knicks.
First foul of the last 2 minutes. Knicks have it, 14 to shoot. We're down to 55 seconds left. Brunson turns the corner on Oubre. Brunson draws the foul and gets the roll. Big bucket for Jalen Brunson. Bernard King did it for the Knicks back in 1984. And he missed it. Rebound. Knocked over to Hield. 111 to 108, 47 seconds to go.
Philadelphia doesn't need a three here.
Embiid looking to give it up. Maxey, we're down to 38 seconds left, 9 to shoot. Maxey gets the step, drives in, can't finish. Foul call.
Wow, that was a good block.
Stunning win. This is for the tie, Maxey. 111, 34.9 on the clock.
Here on the catch, or they play him straight up. Batum on him now. He was on him at the end and causing that turnover in game five.
Get it in. Brunson. Oubre forces him to give it up. Hart hands it to him. Plenty of time on the shot clock. Brunson, drive, swing, Hart. He connects! Huge three! Knicks lead!
Philadelphia.
Sixers are out of timeouts. 24.4 on the clock. They get it in for Embiid. Ananobi there defensively. Embiid turns and scores. He did it quickly. We've got a one-point game. 18 seconds left. Brunson trying to get it up the floor. He does. DiVincenzo caught by Hart. Backs it out. DiVincenzo keep away. 11.1. Foul call. 11.1 to go.
And Ian, if he makes this right here, if you're Tom Thibodeau, do you foul before Maxey or anyone can get into their shot? Certainly we know that hurt them in game five in New York down the stretch.
Trying to make this a three-point game. He hits both. 116, 113. 11 seconds on the clock. Get it in for Maxey. McBride's not going to let him shoot it. 87% shooter, Tyrese Maxey. Second attempt for Maxey. 116 to 115. Get it in for Brunson. Brunson is fouled by Batum. 40 points. New York leads by three. 7.7 on the clock. Get it in for Maxey. DiVincenzo tries to cut him off. He does. Get it ahead. Step in. McBride gets a piece. 3.7.
And how about the defense from DiVincenzo? Stopping Maxey, not letting him get a full steam down the court. Now 3 seconds left. Expect Maxey to try to run into the front court, receive the pass, and try to get into a shot for a three.
Batum to toss it in. Floats it. Hield. Throws it up. It's off. Attrition is won by the Knicks. New York advances to the second round in back-to-back years.
Josh Hart gets inside. Hartenstein right there.
Great action. Right where he always is when you drive the ball. Right there, dotted circle, front of the rim. Hart knows he's there, his sixth assist of the night.
Look at those numbers, 12, 11, and 7 for Hartenstein. Set up by Hart. Now Siakam on the drive. He finds Nimhart. Halliburton passes another one up. Now takes a tough shot and scores. Took a page out of Hartenstein's book right there.
There you go, but it's good to see him. His first shot he's taken in the fourth quarter of this series.
And only the second that he's taken in this second half.
DiVincenzo.
And they move the ball to a three. That's Rick Carlisle's fear. Let's see if they go back and trap him again.
Hartenstein with another assist.
Nimhart got caught in the air. He finds Siakam, though. Nesmith keeps it alive. What do we got here?
Foul.
There's going to be a foul.
Foul on Precious.
J.B. DeRosa comes in for the call on Achiuwa. In there for OG Anunoby. Two for Siakam.
Well, we'll see what Indiana does coming back.
Mavs Thunder. Game two's there. Go to the NBA app or NBA.com.
In these playoffs, this is really where Siakam has struggled from the free throw line, especially down the stretch for the Pacers.
Pacers are 0 for 5 from the free throw line this quarter. Knicks lead it by 5. Ball control here, getting the pace where they want it. Brunson, a three-pointer, no good. And it's DiVincenzo with the board. He finds it. Offensive rebounds turn into second chance points. And the Knicks are up 7. Pacers were down 8 to start the quarter. They're down 7 right now. And Halliburton lets a three fly and hits one. Big shot for the Pacers.
Huge possession right there.
Yeah, and I don't know why Precious Achiuwa is that far back on the pick and roll.
The Knicks, in closing time in game one, the last 4.5 minutes,
coach.
They did not miss. As DiVincenzo gets it to Hartenstein, he's fouled. And they'll send Hartenstein to the line. They have been great finishing off games as Hartenstein calls the board.
You know what they call it when a Knicks starter plays 36 minutes, Brian?
An off night.
A load management.
Load. Okay, good.
Load management.
6-point Knicks lead. And Anobi will now return. Brunson playing with a short left foot. Halliburton just hit a big three. Now he's got a chew on him. DiVincenzo guarding Siakam underneath. Turner's going to let it fly, and he missed it.
You got to get a better shot than that coming down the stretch. A step back for Miles Turner, that's not going to get it done.
Hart and Brunson working together here.
No double team this time.
Pacers need a stop. Knicks trying to add to it. Brunson going to work. Turn around. Good.
And that's when you should go get him, right? When he starts to dance like that,
that's exactly right. When
you got to hit him with a double team.
23 for Brunson, missed the entire second quarter. Siakam, no, Hart the rebound. Knicks can smell it now.
And they've got numbers. Neesmith is down. 5-on-4 here.
Brunson shot fake. And now DiVincenzo gives it back to him with 10 to shoot. 2 minutes to go in regulation.
Here comes the knockout blow.
DiVincenzo, and Neesmith knocked it out of his hands. DiVincenzo, no. Hart with the rebound, no. Loose ball foul on Josh Hart.
That's
and it'll
huge.
Be Pacers ball. Indiana is just 8 of 15 from the line. Halliburton's 4 of 5 now. Pacers trying to win one on the road and go back to Indianapolis even in this series as Halliburton hits a couple of clutch free throws.
If it were me, Reg, and I know he's not a three-point shooter, I would have gotten McConnell back in the game right here on the defensive end.
Nimhard guarding Brunson. He goes 4 fouls.
And here they want to put Halliburton in that screen.
Josh Hart finds DiVincenzo. A three-pointer is good! DiVincenzo delivers again!
And how is Neesmith getting caught so low down on that screen and roll?
Halliburton denied! Couple of Knicks met him at the apex. DiVincenzo strikes again with another big three.
6 of them here on the evening tonight. Late on the rotation, and Dante making them pay. He just gets caught down below Hartenstein.
Pacers ball, Neesmith for 3. That one's good.
What an answer.
Wow.
What an answer. But can they stop? Can they stop anyone, coach?
That's why I'd get McConnell back in the game. He was the one guy giving Brunson some trouble.
Knicks lead by 6. And we got a whistle and a
double dribble. Double dribble.
And it's going to be a Knicks turnover.
Can they take a look at it?
They
took it away.
Yeah. But now, what do you have on the clock?
Rick Carlisle is incensed.
Well, how's it inadvertent? I heard it.
Yeah, it wasn't inadvertent.
I heard the whistle and the call.
That sounds better than I believe the call.
Right. And the signal. He signaled double dribble.
But it does look like he didn't double dribble.
Knicks don't have much time to get this ball over.
No. As soon as it hits 15.
Hart's just got to blow it up.
And he does. Knicks by six.
They're going to get out of the way here and just let Brunson go. Not much time. I come get him now.
Four to shoot. Brunson. Brunson rises up. In and out it goes. And it's a two-on with the board. DiVincenzo missed it. And the ball's loose. Who touched it last? It's going to be Knicks ball. Fifth offensive rebound for the Knicks this quarter. 52.9 seconds left. Knicks looking for a put-away punch right here. And they give the ball to their best player, Brunson. Five to shoot. Brunson drives. Brunson scores! Trying to put the lights out on the Indiana Pacers.
You've got to get McConnell back in. He's the only guy who has given Brunson any trouble in this series.
Carlisle got a tech. That's why Brunson was at the line right there. Got a tech while we were in a break.
And BA, to your point, the Villanova Knicks, 22 of the 27 fourth quarter points. But more importantly, I keep saying that the Knicks' best offense is a missed shot. They are dominating the offensive glass in this fourth quarter once again.
Five offensive rebounds, turn it into six second chance points. Halliburton puts up a prayer. He was looking for a foul. And here comes Brunson. Brunson is fouled. They rise to their feet at Madison Square Garden with 33 seconds left.
Well, Reggie, all we keep hearing about with the Knicks is they play their guys too many minutes. They got to give these guys rest. Hart's on his fourth game of the playoffs playing every minute. Brunson's played every minute of the second half. And yet, they're the ones that make all the energy and effort plays in the fourth quarter.
And again, Carlisle ejected.
Yeah, he just got thrown out, Rick Carlisle. And again, the Knicks doing this with the injury in this game to OG as well. And then going forward, his availability for game three.
That could be massive.
After losing Mitchell Robinson in game one, Brunson adds to his second half total.
They came out way too cool, too casual, not knowing if Brunson was going to play in the second half or not.
In this building
especially.
Brunson misses both.
Pacers got to go quick here. See the numbers for Brunson as Miles Turner will miss a three. DiVincenzo the rebound. And Nesmith's going to get the foul. That'll send DiVincenzo to the line. These Knicks, just winners.
What do you think Jay Wright is saying?
Yeah. And DiVincenzo makes it 130-118. Final score will not be thinking about the grinder that this was as Halliburton hits a three.
Well, and Halliburton ends up with 34, but it's a little deceptive, Reggie. He didn't have much impact on this game in the second half.
No, not at all.
No more fouls. The New York Knicks are going to go up 2-0 in this best of seven Eastern Conference semifinal series. And a rivalry renewed.
But against him, no thanks. Brunson, three-pointer, short. Duren couldn't grab it, but Cunningham able to garner it as they approach the midway point here in the fourth. A five-point Knicks lead. They've been up by double figures several times, but the Pistons keep coming back, led by that man, Cunningham. He's had some help here in the fourth quarter from the bench, including Grimes. Grimes drives, feet inside. Duren gathers and banks it in.
And the Knicks playing small-ish right now. Again, Machua on the bench. Isaiah Hartenstein has 21 minutes, so we probably won't see him, depending on if they ramp him up more.
Brunson looking for an opening. Double team poked away by Fournier. That's his second steal on Brunson. Cunningham kicks it out in the corner. Grimes hesitated. Now fires away. Three-pointer won't go, and a foul on Bogdanovich.
Three
Grimes. And some earlier action. Grimes, three clutch free throws there, and the Pistons have tied the game with 5:22 remaining. Knicks in a real battle against a team with the worst record in the NBA. Brunson guarded by Thompson. Bogdanović quickly releases. Shot won't go. That's a tough shot. And as we hit 5 minutes remaining. Cunningham. Cross court stolen by DiVincenzo. Ahead to Brunson. Brunson drives. Back out DiVincenzo. Three-pointer. Bang!
Just know where each other are on the floor and nowhere to go.
That's the 11th assist for Brunson. Fifth time this year he's in 10 assists or more. Grimes jump shot. Back in the rim won't go, but Durin right there. Bogdanović had his hands on the ball, but Durin's strength. Brunson looking. His three-pointer, shot no good, tipped out Bogdanović, back to Hart. Hart has it knocked away, and a foul.
A ton, put up a ton.
Brunson, Achua, drives inside, a lot of contact there. Shot no good, kept alive, taken by Grimes. Under four to play, Fontecchio to Cunningham, thought about the three, Thompson goes inside. Hartenstein closes. Grimes, three-pointers up. Shot's good. Quentin Grimes gives the Pistons their first lead since the first quarter.
He gives the Knick bench a glare as he runs down the floor. Remember me?
He's got 12 points, all of them here in the fourth. Three and a half to go. Six to shoot. Hart. Gets inside, the floater's up, shot no good. Rebound, Achua lays it up and in. They're tied.
Achua comes in the game as Tom Thibodeau saw the Knicks playing small. Not a good matchup. He went big. Achua and Hartenstein in the game together.
Fourth offensive rebound for Achua. 11th total. 3 minutes to play. Cunningham gets inside. Shot put, won't go. DiVincenzo the rebound ahead to Brunson. Brunson drives inside, stops, hesitates, and puts it in. Timeout, Detroit. Nope, he's not going to call timeout. The Pistons started walking to the bench. And Monty Williams saying, nope, play on.
The players thought it's time for a timeout, and he's like, no, let's go. Plenty of time.
Under 3 minutes remaining. Brunson with 33 points, 11 assists. Cunningham to Fontecchio. Cunningham, he's got 32 tonight. Gets away from DiVincenzo. Steps up, jump shot. Won't go. Hart the rebound.
Cunningham suddenly cold, not making his shots, frustrated with himself.
Brunson, the hesitation, jump shot, puts it in. 35 for Brunson. Knicks back up by four. Grimes calling out a play, asking for a screen. DiVincenzo shuts him off. Grimes gets it back. Up top to Cunningham. Kicks it out in the corner. Thompson a three. That's good. How about the rookie Thompson from downtown shooting 15% from that distance this season?
15% means some of them go in. That one, timely.
Knicks lead by one. Under two to play. Thompson guarding Brunson. Brunson a three-pointer. And Grimes the rebound. Anxious moments here. You can feel the anxiety from the crowd. Minute and a half remaining. Cunningham guarded by Hart. Gets away, lobs it up to Durin. Blocked! Defensive play.
That was incredible.
Shot clock at five. Jalen Brunson on the drive. Kicks it back out to Hart. Hart, foul line jumper. In and out. Hart. Hartenstein battling, knocked out of bounds. Pistons ball.
Cunningham, Duren, Fontecchio, Grimes out there for the Pistons with Thompson. Hart knocks it away. Cunningham being chased up top. Fontecchio, extra pass to Grimes. Shot clock at six. Grimes off the bounce. Running layup is good. What a shot from Grimes. 14 points here in the fourth quarter, and the Pistons lead by one. Brunson looking. Guarded by Cunningham. Fontecchio looking to help. Brunson, three-pointer. Off the mark. Rebound deflected. Chased down. Saved by Grimes to Fontecchio. Knocked away. Hartenstein picks it up. Out to DiVincenzo. 10 seconds to go. He throws it away. Ball loose. Picked up by Brunson. Brunson inside to Hart. Hart banks it in. And a foul. Knicks take the lead. Monty Williams is furious. He thought a foul should have been called. There was so much contact. But Josh Hart with the big bucket and a free throw coming up.
Diving for what seemed to be a loose ball that was right in front of us.
Hart misses the free throw. Saved by Hart. And a whistle and a foul. I think it's before the shot attempt. Won't matter because it's... So Hart now from the line, 3 for 5. Hart knocks that one down. Took it a three-point game. Hart misses another ball, batted loose. Hart picks it up. The game's over. The Knicks win.
Boston and Miami, the Kings and Warriors. Go to NBA.com or visit the NBA app for more. Smith, drive, kick. Vinny Smith hits a three. Did he ever need it? And did the Nets need it as well to take a two-point lead with 3:38 to go?
He was 0 for 13 over the last three games until that one. The Knicks had a breakdown defensively between Brunson and DiVincenzo.
Brunson missed it. Achiuwa got the basket, but he cleared space. And it's a foul on Achiuwa. No basket.
You see the confusion. Both guys go with Bridges. Smith in the lane, and Finney Smith finally makes one, and Chua clearly a push in the back.
No Hartenstein for the Knicks. Sims and Achiuwa have played well in his absence. Johnson trying to keep it away. Turnover, Brooklyn. 3:15 on the clock.
Great defense by Josh Hart.
Brunson into the body of Johnson, short. Rebounded by Claxton. That's 17 rebounds for Nick Claxton to go along with 8 points. And Anobi getting ready to check in. DiVincenzo went for the steal. Bridges, skip pass for Smith. Bridges lines it up. Off the rim. Hart's got the board. Randle in a hurry, met by Johnson. High pass handled by DiVincenzo. Smith playing with 5 fouls. DiVincenzo, kick. Get it back. Tough delivery. Rebound, Bridges. A foul called, a hold against Brooklyn. It was Finney Smith underneath. So the 14th foul against the Nets. Knicks are going to have it on the side. Second personal on Dorian Finney Smith. DiVincenzo sits, replaced by OG Anunoby. Toss it in. Brunson out front. The Knicks trail the Nets by two. 2.5 to play. Brunson just got smacked, no call. Brunson can't hit the three. Long rebound. Finney Smith couldn't break away. And Hart tracks it down. Offensive board for New York. Randle, no hesitation. He buries the triple. Knicks lead by one. We approach 2 minutes to go.
Shooting only 30% on the year from threes. He's made both of his attempts tonight.
Claxton handed off. Bridges. Johnson, touch pass for Smith. 7 to shoot. Smith drives in, flips it up, in and out. Hart's got the rebound. And the Knicks with possession, up by one. Randle cut off, taken away by Dennis Smith Jr. And a foul called on Randle. That is the third on Julius Randle.
It's a tough shot here by Randle. Knocks down a three to give the Knicks a lead. But then now he's playing in traffic. Dennis Smith able to get there and steal a ball from him, Randall with the foul.
14 foul, first in the last 2 minutes. The Nets have shot only 3 free throws tonight. They trail the Knicks by 1. Bridges. Caught by Claxton. Hand it to Bridges. Trying to take the baseline. And a foul called. It's going to send Bridges to the stripe.
As you said, only 3 free throws up until now. But they're going to get to the line with a chance to take the lead. Finally. And we still don't have a missed free throw tonight.
First free throw attempt of the second half for the Brooklyn Nets. They trail by 1. It is rare that you shoot free throws at home and hear that kind of reaction on a miss.
That is for sure.
Bridges shooting it at 84% on the season. This one for the tie. 101-101. 1:28 on the clock. The Burrow battle is coming down to the wire here in Brooklyn. Brunson using the screen, challenges Claxton. Blocked by Claxton! Here's Smith on the move. Smith drives in. Scoop, no. Tipped up in the air. Johnson's got it. It's blocked by Ananobi. And Hart saves it for Randall. Up ahead. Bounce. Back for Randall. Hammer jam!
Incredible defensive sequence by the Knicks to turn it into offense at the other end.
103-101 New York. Under a minute to go. Bridges makes his move. Stumbles. Kicks. Finney Smith. Short. And a rebound grabbed by Randall. 44 seconds to go.
I would have liked to have seen the Knicks push there in transition. I think teams play too slow late in games.
Brunson the cross. Outside Ananobi. 8 seconds on the clock. 28 seconds to play. Hart makes a cut to the rim. Lays it in. Again.
Right, because there's times where you just miss shots, but there's times where you're making mistakes, particularly unforced ones, and they need to learn.
Need the bucket. They've got the bucket. Mikal Bridges cuts it to 2. And now they have to play the foul game against the Knicks. And Brunson, who shoots it at 83%, will get a pair.
Bridges gets space, knocks it down. He's been tremendous tonight. I'm not sure they needed to take the foul that early. Get the ball out of Brunson's hands. See if you can get it to one of these other guys who doesn't shoot the ball as well at the free throw line. He's the only 80-plus percent free throw shooter on the floor.
The Knicks lead by 3. 19.8 on the clock. The Nets had missed 5 in a row before the Bridges jumper. And 1 out of 2.
Well, I was wrong. He was the guy to foul.
1 possession game. 12 seconds left. Nets are down by 3 in a timeout called by John Bull.
Gets the ball after they have to foul you at the other end.
O'Neal gets it in. Bridges, bounce. Johnson fires. Off the mark. Randall's got the rebound. And a foul called with 3.1. Johnson got a good look.
He did. And the Knicks dodged a bullet. This happens a lot. Guys go for a steal, and it creates an open shot. Ananobi goes for the steal. Hart has to rotate. That leaves Cam Johnson wide open. As good as Ananobi's been down the stretch, that's a defensive mistake that he'll hear about from the coaches.
So Julius Randle, chance to make this a 2-possession game with 3.1 on the clock. The Knicks lead by 4. Randle is 7 of 7 at the line. The Knicks are 17 of 18
as a team. Chance to crack 30. Nets have no timeouts remaining. Two out of two. 108-103.
Another fourth quarter collapse for the Nets.
Bridges fires at the horn, and that's it. The Knicks come from behind to knock off the Nets.
Knicks looking for their first lead since the first quarter.
Yeah, the biggest lead has been 1 point.
Brunson runs into McBride, 7 on the 24. Brunson backs in, scoop layup, it's up, it's good! And the Knicks take the lead!
5 consecutive points now for Brunson.
It's another Brunson barrage. It's 93-91. 34 points. Buddy Hield can't hit. Hartenstein is 13th rebound.
Hield misses the last 2 3 balls.
This crowd is bonkers right now.
So is Brunson. He's running amok.
Brunson drives, pulls up, jump shot, got it! Jalen Brunson, born to play basketball. It's a 4-point lead.
Brunson, a right elbow 3 ball. Spinning and winning in the paint. And now stopping and popping again. Igniting, delighting, exciting this crowd. So Brunson, infallible, indomitable. Incredible again with another 34-plus performance.
Real star of the night, Jalen Brunson, once again. No Haliburton, and by the looks of it, I don't think he's going to come back in the game. Siakam, again, he's on a minutes restriction. Nesmith, Hart harassing him, and a foul.
To deny his penetration.
Nimhard.
Nimhard in his office in the paint.
Turner's being guarded by Deuce McBride. Nesmith shot, missed it. Rebound deflected, and a loose ball foul against Turner.
Again, a good defense. Nesmith forcing up a shot. Hartenstein doing a good job harassing him. The Knicks will bring it up.
5 fouls on Turner. Rick Carlisle looking like he's going to have to go down the stretch without his all-star point guard. Brunson guarded by Nimhard. There's the double team. McBride kicks it to Achiuwa. Precious Achiuwa left-handed. No good. Hartenstein right there with the follow.
Hartenstein rising and surprising him. Nobody blocking him out.
12 straight points. Knicks by 6. Nimhard jump shot. Short. Hartenstein just dominating the boards.
Early on, Nimhard was feasting with the mid-range jumper. Not that time.
Brunson brings it back out. McBride fires away. And another loose ball foul. This time Achiuwa drawing the foul as Nesmith will pick up his 5th personal. Eight on the 24. Into the hands of Jalen Brunson. 5 on the 24. Gets away from the double team. Kicks it out in the corner. Achiuwa has to put it up. Just gets it off in time. Off the side. Hartenstein keeps alive. Brunson a 3. Achiuwa, another follow. Won't go. Rebound Shepard.
Brunson had time, folks. He rushed that last shot. No reason to rush it. Look at the time remaining.
Siakam pulls back. Under 3.5 left. Siakam up top. Jalen Smith lines up the 3 and rattles it in. It's amazing. A big man shooting 47% from downtown.
Yeah, he has 14 now off the bench. He likes straight on with the hoop.
That's the Pacers' first points in over 5 minutes. Hart the drive, slips, and is fouled. They might challenge that. It looked like he slipped on a wet court and not necessarily a trip.
So he's doing his job bringing the intangibles as he needs to make these 2 free throws.
Misses the first. By the way, the Pacers scored 36 points in the first quarter.
23 points.
Hart goes 1 for 2. Knicks up 4. 3 minutes remaining.
Nick D has been up for the challenge. Siakam, silent night.
Siakam pulls back. Kicks it back up top. Smith Now chased off the three-point line. The running shot, count it and one. Achiuwa tried to draw the foul, but was not in good position. And a chance for a three-point play for Smith.
Previous Smith straight on with the hoop with a three ball. This time duping and hooping.
They're going to challenge that.
On review, the challenge is unsuccessful. Defender never gets struck in the path. Play stands. As a blocking foul, we're going to shoot one shot.
And he's distinguished himself tonight. He's been a lethal shooter behind the arc, but 15 feet away, he misses.
Knicks have three players in double figures in rebounds. Hartenstein 16, Achiuwa 13, Hart 11. Hart the drive out to DiVincenzo. DiVincenzo the floater in the paint, well short. Achiuwa the rebound, back up, and he's fouled. With 2:29 remaining.
Give Achiuwa one more rebound. 14. Bounding and astounding.
The Knicks are shooting 39% from the field, 22% from three. But a big part of this game is the rebounding in the second half. That's the seventh offensive rebound for Achiuwa.
And he's a poor free throw shooter. Look at on this season, only 60%.
And comes up short there. For his career, he's only at 60%. Last year, he shot a career high 70% for the Raptors.
Needs to get this one down.
Knicks have missed five free throws. Achiuwa connects on the second. It's back to three.
Got to watch Smith. He's been their nemesis. There he is.
He finds Siakam guarded by Achiuwa. They know each other well. The former teammate Siakam pull up jumper's good. And it's a one-point game.
Siakam 15 feet away with the jumper.
18 points for Siakam. Brunson falls down, got poked in the eye. Smith takes it away and throws it down. No call.
So Brunson got hit in the forehead. And just lost it. I guess he was stunned.
Boy, the crowd is furious. Some full court pressure here. DiVincenzo will bring it up. Under 2 minutes remaining. Knicks now down by one. They led by six.
Oh.
Dangerous pass. Brunson gets it back. Shot clock at 10. Brunson drives. Foul. Shot is up. Count it. And one. Jalen Brunson with another answer. And the Knicks are back up by one.
We've seen this type of tenacity from Brunson. The pugnacious play. Indomitable spirit showing it right here as he's energizing. Crowd on their feet chanting MVP. You can see under the basket there. Now you can hear like at a
ooh. Hartenstein the tip, gets it back, kicks it out, and DiVincenzo will set it up.
Hartenstein another bound, folks, 16 for the night.
DiVincenzo the drive, pulls up, jump shot, puts it in.
Again, the perseverance by the Knicks.
Nimhard to Smith.
They want Siakam.
Chance of defense from the Garden crowd. Siakam drives. Layup blocked by Achiuwa. Knocked loose. Picked up by Brunson. Heald is shaken up. Heald is down. Knicks have 5-on-4. Heald is hurt. Brunson shake and bake. Kicks it back out. DiVincenzo, three-pointer. Achiuwa tips it up and in. Timeout Pacers. Bedlam here at the Garden.
Heroes abound tonight for the Knicks, folks. Obviously, it's been Brunson heroics, but what about Hartenstein? 18 rebounds, two shy of his career high, and Precious previously blocking the shot. Remember, Precious blocked the shot of Siakam, and then watch the quantum leap here, the left side of your screen, but a tip in. So, stupendous play by Precious igniting the Knicks down the stretch.
Knicks. 8 offensive rebounds, 3 steals, 2 blocks, 12 points. Siakam drives on Achiuwa, poked away by DiVincenzo. To Brunson, fake, drive, bank shot, no good. Hart to save it, looks and finds DiVincenzo. Another hustle play from Josh Hart.
Run the clock, Devo, what are you doing?
Shot clock at 6. Drives on Siakam, spins, falling away, off the glass, no good. And Smith comes out of the pack, 33 seconds remaining.
Don't foul and don't give up the three ball.
Nimhard, shake and bake, goes inside, layup, missed it. Achua the rebound, throws it away. Shepard is fouled on the pass.
Scenarios like this.
Shepard comes across, heel, gets it. Couple of dribbles, goes inside, layup, missed the layup. Hartenstein the rebound. Finds Brunson. Pacers have to foul. Brunson throws it ahead to DiVincenzo. 39 points and a 6-point lead.
Took a licking, but he kept on ticking, Brunson.
What a night for Brunson. Tonight, he's named an all-star for the first time. Another 40-point gem for Jalen Brunson. Nimhard brings it up. Knicks up 7. Smith double team gets out of that, goes inside, throws it down with 6.9 remaining.
Knicks have to protect the ball, actually to get the ball in first and protect it. You know these guys are going to be swarming.
Art gets it and immediately fouled by Heald.
Brunson, another stupendous game.
This fan base, this city has fallen in love with this team.
Yeah. I might not have to spend any more money this year, Mike. And again, I got to start going out more often.
Hart knocks down the two free throws. Nimhard launches it up. Shot is good with 1.1 remaining. Hartenstein looking to inbound to somebody. Finds DiVincenzo, and that'll do it. 9 straight wins by the Knicks, and another shining moment for the Knick All-Star point guard.
They throw it into Brunson, guarded by Caruso. Clock down to 8. From the left wing, Brunson with the cross. Around the world, lost the handle, got it back. Tough shot for the win! And it rattles out, and we'll play 5 more minutes to see if the Knicks can get the number 2 seed. And ready to play 5 more. Dante DiVincenzo, is this right? It says here on my box score, he's played 47 minutes and 31 seconds. Wow, a lot of tread on the tire there. DeRozan missing the midi, rebounded by the aforementioned DiVincenzo. Brunson into the front court against Caruso. Around the ball screen, DeRozan switches onto him with 9 on the shot clock. They hit Brunson with 2. And an OB in rotation. The Bulls guarding Achua. Hart couldn't squeeze the rebound. Vucevic gets it to DeMar. And here come the Bulls. Stares down Achua, drives it. Sprays it to Green for 3. Way short. Hart might have gotten a piece of it. Shot clock at 10. DeRozan in his sweet spot. Left it short. He'll get another opportunity. Caruso pulls. Finally for the Bulls.
No Hartenstein. No Mitchell Robinson. You've downsized at your center spot with Precious Achua, and it opens up an offensive rebounding opportunity.
Brunson around the Achua screen. Got blocked but fouled from behind. And that's going to send Jalen Brunson to the free throw line. Brunson at the free throw line right now for the Knicks. He is a 85% free throw shooter. Knocks down the first. Hey, coming up next in their last game. Looking spry and light.
You like that reverse jam.
I like the fact he had something to say to Ja after that.
Pelicans have won 4 straight, Mark. Zion Williamson may be playing the best basketball of his career.
White off the screen. Inside. Green! Missed the punch. Good contest by Achua. And New York can take the lead here. Thibodeau calls ear. They flatten it out. And now Ananobi with a ball screen. White picks up Brunson. 3 on the shot clock for DiVincenzo. Got it! New York leading by 2. DeRozan got blocked by Achua. DiVincenzo threw it away. Caruso has it. Up to White. Drives the paint. Wild shot, badly missing. And here comes Josh Hart. And he'll puddle it out.
Get a good shot. I don't know why DiVincenzo was rushing. We just talked about the Knicks turnovers. They're like five over their season average. That's not under duress. That's just rushing in a situation where you're in command of the ball with the lead.
Put two on Brunson again. Inside the open man. Drops a dime like a bank teller. What a pass.
So what is Brunson doing? They are sending two to the ball. They're saying somebody other than Brunson's going to beat us. And he's saying, well, I'm going to beat you. I'm just going to do it with the pass.
White inside. Took the contact and drew the foul this time. He'll get a couple of shots to make it a two-point game potentially. But White at the free throw line. A couple of huge free throws here. An 84% foul shooter drains the first. He's had over 18 in the last three for the Bulls, and another strong afternoon here. Up to 26. Two-point New York lead. Number two seed in the East on the line for New York. Brunson against Caruso. Caruso gets through on the screen. Almost picked his pocket. Great defense. Oh, he peeled him. And Caruso fighting. We're going to have a jump ball with Ananobi and Caruso. The stout, intransigent defense by Caruso paying dividends for Chicago there. Knicks control to Hart. This time it's White on Brunson. Boxes and elbows defensively.
Yeah, how about this little switch quickly by Chicago?
Good wrinkle by Billy Donovan. Brunson lost the ball, and they get the turnover. And a chance to tie for the Bulls. DeRozan in the front court. Rips through, out to Vucevic. One more to White, one more. Caruso, strong. Green couldn't get it. Loose ball, Achiuwa does. And the Knicks maintaining that two-point advantage. Boy, they had a great look at it. Brunson probing. Got through on the crossover. And for the slam. Achiuwa. New York by four with 1 minute to go in overtime. A quick three by White. Hart with the rebound. Brunson on the move. Back to Hart.
Oh, my goodness.
Oh, he wanted to spray it out to one of his teammates standing up on the bench, it looked like.
Again.
Or DiVincenzo.
You did not have the numbers advantage.
DeRozan gets the pass. Brunson shows and recovers. DeRozan got it and one. Over Ananobi and a chance to make it a one-point game.
So miscommunication out front leaves an OG Ananobi scrambling and the best possible outcome for Chicago. Efficient one-possession game.
Brunson brings it across. New York leading by one. If you're just joining us, second place on the line for the Knicks with a win in these final dying seconds. Brunson rejects the screen. Two guys on him. Hart, one more. DiVincenzo, ball fake, and the drive blocked. Hart with the ball. New York leading by three. Timeout Bulls. They've got to play straight up here. 19.5 to go. DeRozan answered the challenge last time, and they barely get it in time. Caruso with the touch action. Inside, lays it home, and it's a one-point contest with 14.4 to go. It's a one-possession game. Full court pressure. Caruso tipped it away. Boy, that was very close.
Alex Caruso looking at his bench saying, do we want to challenge?
Billy here? Donovan hasn't used his yet, and you think maybe why not at this point? DiVincenzo to trigger. Hart off of his knee. That was clearly off of Josh Hart's knee. And now the Bulls will have possession, 13.4 to go. Will the Knicks hang on to second place with a win? DeRozan trying to change the script. Stares down at Chua. DeRozan misses. Brunson with the rebound with 2.1 to play. Pass. And now he looks to double. It's knocked away out of bounds with 1.2 to play.
They've not had a clean inbound.
completion, it feels like, in forever.
Either team with a timeout. They lob it up. It's stolen by Green, but time will expire. That's the way to do it. The New York Knicks, with the victory, will secure the number two seed in the Eastern Conference. Barrett. And it falls.
Oh, man, that's a strong drive there by Barrett.
24 for RJ, 112-108. Trey circles back. Murray gets it off against Brunson and scores.
That's that sweet spot. DJ right there is deadly.
Back to a two-point game. 3.5 left. It was a wild affair for three quarters. This game's really slowed down as the fatigue's starting to set in. Randall, he hits.
He wanted to pass that ball, but had nowhere to go, so that's a tough shot.
10-9-9 for Julius. 114-110. Hawks have hit 11 threes in this game. Trey in the paint, cuts it back to two.
Which is what Robinson won't do on that screen and roll. He won't clamp down or blitz Trey. He's going to set back in the lane, so gave him the ability to get all the way to the rack.
Brunson puts it in. Jalen Brunson, 30 points. Dunk for Hunter. And again, the Hawks cut it back to two. That's 24 points for DeAndre.
Well, again, the Knicks fell asleep on the defensive end.
116-114. 2:25 left. The possessions dwindling to a precious few. R.J. Barrett rises up, and he knocks down a big jump shot. 26 for Barrett. Of course, tonight, Brunson.
And all of three of those guys can get to the lane, so even though they can shoot from perimeter, you still got to be conscious of their drive.
Murray turns, corkscrews, misses.
Oh, it's a good shot. It's a good shot.
And he, under two to left.
He takes that shot every game.
Brunson works it down. Here's R.J. Barrett moving in. Stripped. Barrett got it back. Finds Randall in the corner. His three ball, nothing but net. 13 for Julius Randle, and it's 121-114. Now the Hawks are up against it. They've got to score, and they've got to score quickly.
Yeah, they got to score here.
Trey, ball fake. Finds Capella. Oh, he missed it. Right at point-blank range.
How did he miss that?
121-114. 120 left. Mandatory stop here. Randall, he lost the handle.
Trying to do too much. Hawks did a good job of cutting off the baseline. Forces the turnover.
That keeps hope alive with 70 seconds left. Hawks are down by 7. Trey driving. Trey gets a whistle. Robinson knocked that shot out of there, but a whistle before that. Two-possession game.
Right, they're going to milk the clock, and they're not going to be in any hurry.
And Brunson fouled by Trey.
And Brunson was going to keep that ball in his hand. He was going to make the play happen.
First of the last 10 to 15. Second shot. The sixth-year man from Villanova. This is good. 31 for Brunson. Murray to the paint. They crowd Hunter. He steps back to free himself and drains a big three. 27 for Hunter, 122-118.
How he made that.
Boy, that was a tough contested three, wasn't it?
Brunson doubled. Oh, loose ball. Trey's got it. He gets fouled by Grimes. And that stops the clock with 29.4. He's got two free throws coming.
Why in the world would you foul there? And what in the world was Grimes thinking about?
A second free throw for Trey Young to cut it to two. Yes. Hawks will have some time coming back. Oh, they throw it away! Oh, my goodness!
You know what? I'm going to say this now, Bob. New York don't deserve to win this game.
What a mistake! Robinson back. Atlanta could tie with a two and lead with a three. The Knicks have gift-wrapped this one. Can the Hawks unseal the victory? Trey to the basket. Yes. Capella missed it! And the Knicks get the rebound. I can't believe it. Wow. Two at the rim. Yes. Randall, one assist away from a triple-double. Got it.
And if you're New York, you don't want to foul.
Trey's going to get a layup, and he missed that. Randall's got the rebound, and let's see if the Hawks foul. They do. With 7.2. Well, these fans who have stuck it out to the end here, Neek, are just stunned with what they saw.
Yeah, yeah.
Not only the fact that, you know, New York coughed it up like they did and made mistakes to give the Hawks an opportunity, and then they're stunned that the Hawks couldn't capitalize.
And that was it, because the Hawks had many chances in this game.
Julius puts it in. Okongwu comes in. Second shot for Randall with 7.2. I mean, there is no better guy to catch a lob than Clint.
Yeah.
And the one that he fumbled cost the chance for a tie. Julius misses the second, but gets his own rebound. And the Hawks commit another foul with 4.3. What a strange night.
A strange finish. I mean, because the Hawks, they came down five straight possessions in the fourth and could not score. So you gave yourself all the chances you need. I mean, and at the time, it was, what, a two-point game?
Yeah, either one or two. And the Knicks are going to walk out of here with a win to even their record. And the Hawks will head to Milwaukee 0-2. I thought for all the world, when New York turned it over at midcourt, I said, you know, that's it.
Hawks have
they
it.
Have made the fatal mistake. And it did not go the Hawks' way tonight. The horn sounds, and Atlanta suffers a defeat for the first time in 6 years in a home opener. Rick Brunson got to be proud of his son with the way he played tonight. Hawks and Knicks.
Tonight have an update on Quentin Grimes, who went out of the lineup and into the locker room in the third quarter with what looked to be an injury to his hand. Meanwhile, Trey Young skips to the basket and banks it down to give Atlanta a one-point lead. Randall quickly turns, keeps his dribble alive. Pick and roll with Hart. And a foul coming up on Murray, his first. And that will send the Knicks to the line. Hawks over the limit quickly.
Who wants free ticket?
A 90% free throw shooter on the season.
That's a jinx, 90%.
Short on that one, but this is a good sign that the Knicks are getting to the free throw line. It really is. They have the Hawks in the penalty, so continue to get to that line, but you have to cash in your free throws.
And we are level at 103. Fifth tie of this game. Young brings it up. Johnson, Capella, Murray with it, mid-range, and hits. Julius Randle draws a double, wide open quickly. They close on him with Murray. He'll roll down the lane, takes the contact, and will go to the line.
Yeah, Manuel quickly stepping up. I notice in this fourth quarter, the Hawks are taking the ball out of Jalen Brunson's hands. When he comes off those high horn set pick and rolls, they're doubling him, getting the ball out of his hands. They want someone else to make a play to beat him. And Emmanuel quickly says, okay, you want someone else to make a play? I'll make a play. He's making plays in this fourth quarter.
Grimes will not return to the game. He has a left hand injury. So Tom Thibodeau without R.J. Barrett, who didn't play in this game for the second consecutive ball game with migraines. Now Grimes injured. Second free throw goes down. 105-105. 2:35 to go in regulation. Murray. Step back 16. Bam.
Nice move. That's two mid-range jumpers for DeJounte Murray, who closed the game last night for them against Detroit, and he's making big shots down the stretch.
Hawks up by two. Randle backing his way down in the paint. Kicks it out in the corner. Brunson. And answers. Jalen Brunson. Another three. 108-107 Knicks.
Six threes for Jalen Brunson.
Murray with a crossover to the hole. Blocked by Mitchell Robinson. Great help defense by Robinson. 140 to go. Can the Knicks hold on? Up by a penny. Brunson drives, gets there, kicks it. Hart, runner, and good. Lion Hart. Josh Hart makes it a 110-107 game. Inside, Jalen Johnson from Young, and a foul on the floor.
To the rim. Nice, strong finish.
Fourth foul on Hart. Murray. Trey Young. Draws the foul behind the three-point line. On quickly. His third. Tom Thibodeau can't believe it.
And this is a big call. Was Trey Young in the shooting motion? That's the question. Yes, he was. I think they're going to give him three shots.
More coming for Young. And this one could be the equalizer.
Yeah, that was a big call. But the Knicks still in the driver's seat. Minute 13 to go. They have the ball in their hands. They have to execute down the stretch here, get good shots, get good looks, and continue to crash the offensive glass for extra possession.
Seventh tie of the game. 110-110. 110 to go. Brunson, Randle, looking. Randle backs his man down. Randle in the paint. Turnaround Jay. No good. Hart with the rebound. 50 seconds to go. Knicks will get another shot at it. Eight to go. Brunson tightrope into Randle. Double pump up and in. Julius Randle gives the Knicks a 112-110 lead with 40 seconds of play in regulation. Young. And he's fouled. And it looks like this will go against Julius Randle. His fourth.
Extra possessions, Gus. The hustle by Josh Hart to get that offensive rebound. A scrambling defense on the Atlanta Hawks leads to the layup for Julius Randle. And boy, Trae Young is a master at getting you to just reach in enough where he alerts the referee of that contact and gets himself a trip to the free throw line.
Young with 11 points, 16 assists. Correction, 15 points and 16 assists. 112-111, he missed one. Here's Brunson. In and out dribble, pull up 16, footer, got it! The burner! Young quickly guards the ball. Murray drives to the basket, off the glass and in. 114-113. Knicks trying to play keep away. Randle almost had his pocket picked. Quickly, and he's fouled in the backcourt with 8.9 to go, and you're going to send a 90% free throw shooter to the line. And he'll get a pair. Bogdanović. Young. Here's Bogdanović to level. That one out of bounds, no good, with 4.7 to go. DiVincenzo looking. Brunson breaks to the ball. And that's a 5-second violation. Brunson couldn't get it.
That is a crucial mental error.
This one throw, Murray. And the foul before the shot.
Make sure you clean the glass after that second shot.
Jonte Murray at the line. First one good.
Trae Young. When that shot's released, they can sneak in there.
And Murray missing that one on purpose. Did he step over the line? Lane violation. And he did. So Atlanta turns it over. Knicks holding on to a two-point lead. But they had trouble getting the ball inbounds the last time they touched it. DiVincenzo will get another try at it. Hart. Quickly. Brunson. Robinson. And they find Brunson in the backcourt. He'll just dribble around and that's it. The Knicks.
.345 remaining here in the fourth. Knicks have cut it to six, as close as six here in the fourth. Barrett comes out to get it. Barrett struggles a bit with the dribble, gets it back, flips it up, shot is good.
Size, strength, left-handed.
I just like when Barrett is going downhill. He has those big shoulders. He's going to get to the bucket. I wish he would do it more.
Julius Randle back in the game for the Knicks with 3:15 remaining. Lowry to Richardson. Jaquez back up top. Richardson inside out of bio. Hartstein went for the fake. Tough shot out of bio. Missed it. Short. Quickly the rebound with 3 minutes remaining. Brunson thought about throwing it ahead. Now drives on Butler. Gets inside. Layup. He backs it in. And the foul. And Brunson shaken up. He took a shot as he cuts the lead to five. But he's hurting. Brunson gets knocked down numerous times every game. Just so tough. But this one, he looks shaken up.
Playing off the miss. Has Jimmy Butler to beat. That's not easy to do. Oh, yeah.
Oof. Adebayo picks up his third. And Brunson trying to gather himself to hit a free throw that would cut it to four. Remember, this game was a one-point game at halftime. The Knicks led. Heat dominated the third, led by as many as 21, by as many as 18 here in the fourth. And here a chance to cut it to four. Brunson, 18 points, but misses an important free throw there. Butler calling for the ball against Barrett. Goes back door. And a foul. It's going to go against R.J. Barrett. That whistle probably beneficial. Butler was about to get a layup.
The pick that Kyle Lowry just set. I mean, this is what veterans do, Mike. Like, young guys would never set picks like this. It's such a terrific pick, but you're right. It would have led to a layup.
Two KG veterans, Butler and Lowry, doing what they do here in the fourth quarter on the road. Butler gets it back. Thinks about a three, puts up a three, in and out. Rebound Lowry, but a loose ball foul is going to go against Kyle Lowry. And not in the penalty yet, that's the 14th foul, second on Lowry.
Feels like quickly has been involved in every big play for the Knicks.
It really has in their defense, their energy. All of a sudden, Miami getting down to 1 and 2 seconds on the shot clock before they were early into the shot clock.
The Heat now 3 for 16 from the field here in the fourth quarter. Brunson, the crossover, the step back, leans in, puts it up, puts it in, and the foul! Jalen Brunson with a chance now to cut it to two with 2:20 remaining.
As soon as he picks up the ball, you're in a little bit of trouble. Because his footwork is so outstanding. You think you've done your job, he gets you crossed. You step up to him, and as soon as you make that step up to recover, he goes right by you with that footwork. That is too good.
That was where the young player was schooled by the veteran player.
That time he hits the free throw. Two-point game, just under 2.5 remaining. Knicks trying to have a huge comeback here in front of this raucous crowd. Butler drives, puts it up, tried to draw the foul. R.J. Barrett. Barrett drives, goes it out of bio. Ben Shadows goes, the game is tied, and the foul. Knicks with a chance to take the lead.
This is just a great play by R.J. Barrett. Take the hit. Morris, what did I say? Put your shoulder in him. That's what he does. When he plays downhill, he's a completely different player.
And uses his offhand, the right hand. Knicks lead. 1:59 remaining, and the Garden has exploded here on the fourth. Richardson the drive. Up top. Hawkins got quickly on him. He likes the height advantage. Puts it up. Short. Brunson the rebound. Knicks have outscored the Heat 26-9 here in the fourth quarter. Seven on the 24. Brunson drives, pulls back, jump shot. It's good!
So he's calling the rookie over. He purposely looked at IQ and said, bring Hawkins to me. I got him the last time. I'm going to get him this time. I got him with a crossover the last time. I'm going to get a crossover again this time. Back-to-back plays. He says, bring him here. I got him.
I don't think he's going to have that opportunity anymore.
No.
That's probably right.
It's been a 21-point turnaround here in the fourth as the Heat led by 18 at one point here in this period. Now they trail by three. Into the hands of Jimmy Butler. Butler drives on Barrett. Pull up, jump shot. Won't go. Randall the rebound. Nothing going down for the Heat here in this fourth quarter. 3 for 19 from the field. Randle coming to set a screen. Brunson the drive. Barrett, three-pointer. Lowry, a running start. Goes right at Brunson. Back to Adebayo. Oh, the slam won't go. Randle the rebound. Five seconds remaining. Knicks clinging to a three-point lead. Richardson playing up. Brunson five to shoot. Three-pointer. Rebound deflected out of bounds. Last touch by Randle. He wants a challenge, but they've already used theirs. And the Heat will inbound with 21.8 remaining. Each team has a timeout. Doc, is it too early to foul to not let a three-pointer tie?
It's too early.
Lowry to Adebayo, gets inside, layup. What a foul by Hartenstein, and Bam Adebayo with two huge free throws here, 15 seconds remaining.
It's a challenge, but he back-rimmed a dunk and then missed a layup.
Well, we talked about it earlier in the game that the Heat were up, but they were missing shots. The problem was the Knicks were not scoring.
The Heat have now made 20 consecutive free throws. Tom Thibodeau will use his final timeout. Brunson looking, gets it into quickly. Quickly back out to Brunson. Brunson double team and a foul.
Really
16 from the free throw line. They have not shot free throws well this season. Overall as a team. Brunson and quickly are two exceptions.
See if they can get it up, but you lose too much clock. You almost have to.
Misses the second.
Now they're going.
The Heat do not obviously need a three-pointer. 6 seconds to go. Butler has it. 4 seconds to go. Butler step back. Three-pointer. Won't go. Randle the rebound and it's over. The Knicks with a thrilling comeback here at home at Madison Square Garden.